Good morning, students. Sairam, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. So students, we have completed our 8 chapters. Okay, so in this video we are going to start our next chapter, which is financial management. Okay, so what is the meaning of financial management? Before starting this chapter, let's discuss what is the meaning of finance. Means, what do you understand by the meaning of finance? Finance means the amount of money which we require to meet the daily expenses of our business, okay? Or to start a business, to expand a business, means the whole amount of money which we required for running and starting a business is known as finance, okay? So, what is the meaning of business finance? Business finance is that business activity which is concerned with the acquisition and conservation of capital fund in meeting financial needs and overall objective of business enterprise. Understood? So, I hope you all have understand what is the meaning of finance. So, student, the question is arises that why do we need finance in a business? To setting up a business, to meet the need to finance our day-to-day activities, for expansion of the business, for research into new product, like for purchasing new machinery, new technique, okay, or special situation as fall in the sales. So these are the reason why we need a finance. Okay, now financial management. Students, management, as you all know, na, management means to manage all the activities of the business. Now we are going to learn about the financial management. So financial management means we have to manage all the activities which is related to the money of the, which is related to the business finance. So what is the definition of financial management? Financial management, look student, management has 5 functions. What are they? Planning, organizing, directing, controlling and staffing. But financial management means management of finance. So it covers the 4 functions of management, which is planning, organizing, directing and controlling. The financial activities such as procurement and utilization of the fund of the enterprise. It means applying the general management principle to financial resources of the enterprise. Look students, financial management means first we have to think that from where we acquire money, means what are the sources of fund from where we acquire money, and after that we invest what we have to plan that from where we have to invest our fund, and after investing and after getting profit, next question arises that what we do with our profit. We secure that part of a product as a retained earning, or we reinvest that profit. So these are some questions which we manage in the financial management. As I said again, it is the planning, organizing, directing and controlling of financial activities of the business, means like acquisition of fund or procurement or utilization of fund and reinvestment or save as a retained earning. So what is this? This is a financial management. Now role of the financial management. What is the importance? What is the role of financial management? Like the role of financial management comes under the 5 points. Like number 1 is determination of fixed asset. Look students, there are 2 type of assets in our, if in any business, fixed assets and current assets. Fixed assets are those whose life are more than 1 year, and current assets who convert into cash in within a 1 year. So what amount of money we have to invest in a fixed asset and what amount of money we have to invest in a current asset. So the determination of fixed asset, determination of current assets, what how can we decide? By the financial management, means for the deciding the amount of money invested in a fixed and current assets, we have to decide in a financial management. means it help us to the determination of fixed and current assets. Next one is the another role of financial management is determination of proportion of long term and short term finance. Means what are the sources? Okay, so after deciding the sources, the next point is to the proportion of long term and short term. Means we have to invest in a long term plan, long term investment, or we have to invest in a short term investment, short term project. So financial management also help us to decide that. Next one is determination of proportion of various sources of long term finance. As I said, we have to decide the proportion of long term and short term finance. Means both points are linked together. Determination of proportion of long term and short term finance. As we know, there are many sources of fund. We have already learned earlier in our earlier class in 11, like retained earning, equity shares, debenture, trade credit. Okay, so we have to decide that what kind of resource we need, short term, long term. Okay, now next one is determination of various item of profit and loss. Look, for that we have the various items in profit and loss account, means our incomes, our expenses. So we have to determine, and how we can determine, how can we spend our money or distribute our money in that items according to the planning in financial management. So what is the role of financial management? It helps to determine the fixed asset and current assets, the proportion of long term and short term source of finance, determination of proportion of various sources of long term finance, and determination of various items of profit and loss account. Now, objective. So student, what is the main objective of a management, a financial management? So the main objective of any business activity is to profit maximization. But if we talk about a big organization, if we talk about the financial management, because a financial management is required in a big organization, so profit maximization is our primary motive. The next one is wealth maximization, wealth of shareholders. So the wealth maximization is the another objective of financial management. Means financial management means how we manage our money. Okay, so the its main objective is to provide a framework for optimum financial decision making. They are concerned with designing a method of operating the internal investment and financing of a firm. There are two widely discussed approach under this. These are profit maximization and wealth maximization. Look student, what is the main role we have learned earlier? That what is the main role of financial management? It helps us to decide, to take decision whether we invest in a short term plan, in a long term plan, what the sources of fund we opt, long term, short term, how much we invest in our fixed asset, how much we invest in our current assets. Okay, so it helps us for these decision. So what is their main aim, what is their main objective behind it? What are their objective? Profit maximization, and another one is wealth maximization. And wealth maximization related to the shareholders' wealth. Okay, now look students, in financial management there are some financial decisions are there. Means some decisions which we have to take if we are doing financial management. Why we do financial management? For making our financial decision. Okay, so what are the categories of these financial decision? These categories are investment decision, financing decision, and dividend decision. So these are the decisions concerned with the financial matters of a business firm, and their aim is to maximize. And what is their aim? Their aim is to maximize the shareholders wealth. Some examples: the kind of assets to be acquired, pattern of capitalization, distribution of firm's income, etc. Okay, so what is the main aim? Is to maximize the shareholders' firm. Now, if we do a financial management, some decision we have to take. So these financial decision are categorized in three categories. Number one is investing decision, financing decision, and last one is dividend decision. Look, student, investing means where we have to invest, for long term, for short term. Financing decision means what are our sources of fund, from where we acquire money, whether from debentures, whether from equity shares or preference shares. Now, dividend means the amount of profit which we distribute to the shareholder after getting profit. Dividend means the amount of profit which we distribute to the shareholders is known as dividend. So dividend decision means, but after getting profit, what proportion of the profit we have to keep with us, or what proportion we have to distribute among our shareholders. So these are some decision. Now, like financial decisions, number one is investing decision. Capital-based budgeting means we have to invest our money in a long-term process, or in for a fixed assets. Or working capital decision means we have to invest in a current assets. Okay, so two decisions we have to take, whether we invest in a capital or whether we invest in a current. But there may be also a proportion, like if we have a 100% amount of money, so 60% we invest in our capital budgeting, means for fixed assets, and 40% we will invest in our current assets. Okay, so these are some decision which is related to the investment decision. Next one is financing decision. Financing means from where we get money or from where we raise money. So we have to raise money whether by issuing debentures or whether by issuing shares, equity. Okay, now dividend decision means after getting profit, what amount of money we have to give or distribute among our shareholders as a dividend, or what amount of money we have to retain with us for our future use. So these are two important decision comes under the dividend decision. Dividend decision means the amount of money that the profit which we get after our production, after the selling of our product. If, for example, if we get the 40 lakh as a profit, and after eliminated all expenses, so in 40 lakhs, what amount of money means what proportion of money we have to save as general reserve, or we can say that save as retained earning, or what amount of proportion we have to distribute in among our shareholders. This we have to decide. Okay, what is the main reason behind saving or retained earning? That retained earning amount we will use in our future as an investment, or for meeting our future losses, or recover our losses, for meeting uncertainties, or for reinvestment. Some are the examples for using the retained earning. So students, these are three financial decision. Number one is investment decision, second is financing decision, and third one is dividend decision. Okay, and so this is the introduction of your chapter number 9, financial management. So let's review again. What is the financial management? Financial management means to manage financing. Financing means finance, the money which we require to run our business, to expand our business, or to meet the financial expenses or daily expenses. So why we do financial management? For taking some decisions, and these decisions are related to investment decision, financing decision, and dividend decision. Investing means what amount of money we have to invest, whether in our capital goods, means in our fixed capital, fixed assets, or whether in our current assets, or what proportion we have to invest. Next, financing decision means from where we acquire money, from where we raise money, from debenture or from equity or from both. Same as in a dividend decision, we have to take the decision about the distribution of profit in the ratio and between the retained earning and the dividend. So students, in detail these decisions we will study in our next video. So thank you. Sairam.